Good morning, dear students. During the last video, we have learnt about the human digestive system. Basically, in the human digestive system, we have learnt about the two parts, alimentary canal, this full pipe, alimentary canal, and other one is digestive glands, like salivary glands, okay, pancreas, liver, these are the digestive glands. In the alimentary canal, we have learnt about mouth, esophagus, stomach, small intestine, large intestine, rectum and anus. And we also learnt about the functions of each and every part of the alimentary canal. Basically, the human digestive system having five processes: ingestion, digestion, absorption, assimilation, egestion. Ingestion means intaking of food. Digestion means breaking down of food molecules into smaller molecules. Absorption means absorbing of the food in the form of nutrients. Assimilation means utilization of energy. Egestion means removal of the wastes from the body. These two, ingestion and digestion, we have learned. Now we are going to start absorption. First of all, what is absorption? Absorption is the process in which the food is absorbed in the nutrients into our bloodstream. Means food is properly absorbed in the bloodstreams. Mostly this absorption is held in small intestine. This is the figure of small intestine. This is the inner lining of small intestine. The inner lining of small intestine having finger-like projections, means finger-like structures that are known as villi. Singular, it is known as villus. Small intestine, this is small intestine. This small intestine having finger-like projections, means finger-like structures, that is known as villi. This villi having these blood streams, these girl-like structures are blood streams, means you can say blood capillaries also, tube-like structures that are known as blood capillaries. Main function of villi is to increase the surface area for proper absorption of food in the small intestine. Means whenever the digested food is going to small intestine, these villi increases the surface area so that proper absorption of food will occur. When the proper absorption of food is going to occur, after that the nutrients going to these blood streams, these blood vessels. From these blood capillaries, all the nutrients going to each and every part of the body. When each and every part of the body gets proper nutrients, they get full energy. That energy helps to do so many kinds of activities. That is known as assimilation. Assimilation means the utilization of the energy, utilization of the food in the cells. Whenever the digested food is properly absorbed with the help of villi, after that there is utilization of the food in the cells to produce energy, that is known as assimilation. Means whenever food is properly absorbed, it produces energy. That process is known as assimilation. That energy helps us to do so many activities like walking, talking, studying, each and everything. And it also helps to repair the old blood vessels, our body cells also. It helps to repair our body cells and also to produce the new cells. This is assimilation. Again, two processes: absorption and assimilation. Absorption is the process whenever the absorbed food goes to small intestine, This absorbed food produces the nutrients which are going to blood vessels. From the blood vessels, it going to each and every part of the body and produces energy which helps to do so many activities. And also it helps to form the body cells. And last process is egestion. The process in which the undigested food removed from the body. That process is known as egestion. Now come to the disorders. Although our digestive system helps to produce energy to do so many kinds of activities, but if our digestive system is not doing work properly, its functioning is improper, then we have to face some problems. We have to face some diseases also. Due to the improper functioning of the digestive system, basically three disorders are there. First is vomiting. Vomiting means whenever there is opposite peristaltic movement of anything which is present in our stomach. The opposite movement of the substances through our mouth from the stomach, that is known as vomiting. Means whenever our digestive system is not doing the work properly, it's facing a problem, then the food particles and other thing which is present in the stomach, that is move out of the body through mouth, not from anus, that is known as vomitings. Second disorder, diarrhea. Diarrhea means whenever we are going to facing some dehydration problems, there is excessive loss of water from the body, and also it leads to dehydration. That problem is known as diarrhea. Indigestion. Indigestion means not properly digested. Means constipation problems, constant symptoms in our body. That process is known as indigestion. Means whenever we are feeling some problems of like gas, acidity, that problem is indigestion. Means in which the food is not properly digested in our digestive system and we have to face the constipation problems. These are the three main disorders of our digestive system. Up to this, thanks a lot.